Here. Am I late?
Only about 30 minutes.
Sorry, I got a little lost on the way here. I have two kids switching here for school next week, and I want to get some more information on Terrapolis.
Well, I'm the guy you're looking for. I teach history and geography here at Terrapolis East High School, and I've lived here for all of my life. Why did you decide to switch schools?
Well, I got a job transfer, and my family moved here from New York. We're a bit confused.
Wow, that is quite a long transfer. I'd be happy to tell you more. I'm Isaiah, and this is Eric, the city planner.
Hi, nice to meet you.
In Terrapolis, we like to brag about our garbage, energy, and transportation systems. They are all known around the world for their innovation.
All those were mostly designed by me.
That's pretty cool, but first, so I don't get lost again, what's the layout of the city? Oh yeah, and also, what's the weather like?
The weather here is mild, with an average temperature of 60 degrees. The area is fairly flat, with some little hills. And for the layout, Terrapolis is located on the coast of Oregon. It has high density downtown area near the coast, and as you get farther from the coast, lower density areas. The population is about 105,000.
Wow, the layout doesn't sound that confusing anymore. Maybe I won't get lost next time. So how does this garbage system you talked about earlier work?
I'll take this one. In Terrapolis, we have a waste collection and disposal system that is well known to be friendly to the environment, energy efficient, and improves the quality of life for citizens.
We accomplish this by the use of a system consisting of an underground vacuum waste collection system, which delivers the trash to either a biodigester, plasma gasification, or a recycling center.
With this system, taking out the trash is a thing of the past.
It sounds really cool. Could you explain in more detail? It sounds intriguing.
Sure. First, a waste inlet center in each user's living area will have separate labeled inlets for recyclable, biodegradable, and other waste. When waste is put into an inlet, it is bagged with the corresponding color-coded bag. When the bag fills, the waste is released. The garbage then gets sucked to the disposal center as geothermal-powered compressors create a suction. That noise was the model compressor. At the disposal center, the bags are robotically sorted based on the color. They are then sent to the appropriate disposal sites by conveyor belts.
Wow, I would assume the system means that garbage trucks are a thing of the past.
Yep, removing garbage trucks from the city environment greatly improves the health and safety and reduces traffic jams, air and noise pollution, and pests.
One trade-off of the system is the high cost of construction, but the operating cost is much lower.
Cool. What does that biodigester you said about talk
the
about?
The biodigester creates clean-burning methane fuel and fertilizer from organic waste. The inputs include waste from Terrapolis and agricultural waste from Terrapolis underground farms. In the digesters, anaerobic microorganisms break down the organic matter in the absence of oxygen, which leaves methane and fertilizer.
A trade-off of the biodigester is the value of land nearby being reduced because of the smell. We eliminated this trade-off by putting the biodigesters underground.
Ew, I would not want to live next to that. Good thing it's underground. What materials does a recycling center accept?
We accept plastics, metals, glass, carbon fiber, papers, cardboard, as well as many other items. This waste is sorted by machines based on density, types of light reflected, and other physical properties. From here, recyclables are crushed down, resulting in the output of useful raw materials for Terrapolis to use and sell. Recycling materials, instead of making them from scratch, also uses less energy and valuable resources.
What happens to waste that cannot be recycled or biodigested? In other cities, it's just goes to a landfill.
In Terrapolis, a plasma gasification plant is used. The plasma gasification plant's inputs are non-recyclable and non-organic waste, as well as hazardous and medical waste. A plasma arc breaks the waste down into basic elements. After the waste has been broken down, it cools and reforms into syngas and slag. Syngas is then burned to produce electricity. Slag can be used as a substitute for asphalt. The resulting outputs are electricity, CO2 used in plant growth, and a substitute for asphalt. One trade-off is the high energy use.
That's pretty cool. So the extra garbage is also turned into asphalt, CO2, and building materials?
Yep. Terrapolis also has a great waste reduction system that practically eliminates food packaging waste.
What happens to electronic waste in Terrapolis? I heard that it can cause many environmental problems if not disposed of properly.
Electronic waste will be handled at a citywide e-waste recycling plant. This reduces the amount of e-waste that is dumped in landfills and also allows for the reuse of rare metals. Adding an e-waste recycling facility was a hard decision as it is extremely costly and uses a lot of energy.
What engineers help with the planning and construction of Terrapolis? I would assume building a city this complex would require quite a few.
You got it. Well, let's see. Civil, mechanical, electrical, chemical, computer, geotechnical, and many, many more. Engineers play a crucial role in not just the construction of Terrapolis, but every city in the world.
For example, civil engineers designed the underground pipeline that is required for our collection system.
Speaking of engineers, how is power and water produced in Terrapolis?
Power is produced with a special type of geothermal plant, which does not need to be located in a geothermally active area. This works by using graphene rods that are near perfect conductors of heat. These rods conduct heat from deep down in the earth up to the surface where the heat boils water. The steam then turns a turbine which produces electricity. This is just as clean as previous generations of geothermal power, but can be used anywhere in the world and does not cause an increased amount of earthquakes.
Water is produced by using the same graphene geothermal technology. The heat from the graphene rods distills salty seawater, which produces purified water for the city of Terrapolis. This method of water distillation is still extremely energy intensive, but is not a concern because it is geothermal power.
When I was driving here, I noticed a cool glass building. What was that?
That is our Terrapolis Stadium. It is known all around the nation for its design. It has giant platforms under the ground, and they each hold a field. If the field is desired, the platforms will then use cranks and pulleys to come up to field level and lock into place. Then you can play away. We also have reclinable seats. In the cold weather, the seats come up, and in the hot weather, they go back down for fans' great experience.
One of the great buildings I planned and designed. I never would have been able to design the city without that computer modeling program and the engineering design process. Oh, and Terrapolis also has an innovative transportation technology. We have an underground vacuum maglev subway network for higher density areas of the city, as well as electric supercapacitor vehicles that can charge in as little as 5 minutes off of power from the geothermal plant.
Wow, that's pretty cool. I can't wait to live here.
You bet. I've lived here pretty long and I enjoy it quite a bit. Oh, and if you want my essay, you can grab a copy on the way out.
Thanks.
See you later.
The coast affect any of your design?
It did actually. We could have a water distillation plant, which allows more water and to be used for the underground farms, and just it's easier to get to. And with the new graphene technology, using distilling seawater is really easy and energy efficient.
Another thing is that for a geothermal plant, once we found that you could have geothermal without being in a geothermally active area, it really helped because in geothermally active areas, earthquakes are way increased. Mm-hmm. So that was a way that we could solve that with moving to the coast.
Yeah, we were originally going to be located near Yellowstone.
Yep.
What about, as far as for your citizens, the needs that they have now, health care and emergency services and items like that?
Well, we have our hospital back there, police station right here, and a school right here, right next to the residential area. And as far as like recreational activities go, in the stadium, when there isn't games, we have a mini golf field that comes up, and they can go do that.
So, yeah, you can see the extra fields from the stadium underneath there.
Looks like there are some things drawn into the hillsides in the back. About that, or are those roads?
You can see the roads going up, but the gray things are just supposed to be buildings.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what it's supposed to be.
All right.
It's supposed to be like it's on a hill.
Got it.
It's not just a floating building.
Is clean air a concern for you guys?
It is. Our city practically has no carbon, there's no carbon footprints, and there's barely any air pollution. All of our energy is clean energy right here, and we have the graphene supercapacitor cars, and then we also solved the problem of like bigger heavy duty vehicles, like maybe semis or other vehicles like that. We use hydrogen combustion engines, and the hydrogen is produced by water from the distillation plant and electricity from the geothermal plant.
Another thing, as we explained in our presentation, getting rid of garbage trucks off the road greatly improves air pollution and the noise pollution with out the your classic 5:30 garbage trucks coming through and waking you up.
Yeah, we have just listed here health and safety, no more pests,
yep.
Garbage cans never overflow. It's great.
Mm-hmm.
I might have one more question. You guys, you, mentioned lots of different kinds of engineers at the university. Mentioned lots of different kinds of engineers, but I wondered if you could connect some of those to the kind of work that they might have done in the city.
Yeah, sure. I'll just find the...
Oh, well, to start, we have the geotechnical engineers. Obviously, the geo matches up with this. They helped, they would help build the, completely design the geothermal area and the technology that we use there.
Yeah, also the electrical engineers designed our whole electrical system. There's many different pieces. It's only the electrical grid. All of our grid is underground. There's no ginormous above-ground transmission lines. And then, civil engineers. I touched on that in the presentation, but they design so much of the city.
And then another thing we mentioned computer engineers. They're big because our vacuum system is completely run by computers. So if we didn't, they would completely take control of the underground pipeline and get the garbage where it needs to be. And yeah, so they're big.
Yeah, and the whole system is computer controlled. We designed it, so I wasn't able to get to this, but when you tell say that you want the trash to leave, it connects to a computer network and make sure that there isn't a large volume of trash being released at the time to stop cloggages, otherwise that would be a big problem.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.